are almost live.
Yeah, we're good to go, man. We're on Facebook. We're rocking and rolling.
Are we on?
You're live.
We are on. Welcome back, everybody. Michael LaFido here, Luxury Lunch and Learn. We have a last second guest, and I'm really excited to have him. For those of you that have perhaps were connected through LinkedIn or through Facebook, and from time to time you get my emails with videos, educational videos. That is a service I use through viral marketing. And Frank, I have on as today's guest. So Frank, say hello to everybody.
Hey, everybody. What's up?
Frank and I have known each other, I'm trying to think, probably back since 2011, 12.
Yep. We met initially at a Dan Kennedy conference in Chicago.
Yes. Yes, that is that's exactly right. We met at a conference in Chicago, actually.
Yeah.
And let's reconvene, and we're talking about when we met. You were just starting your company, talking about email marketing, and so your company is really simple, and we're helping agents, Frank, and those that are in the industry, increase their average sale price. We launched this show on April 10th due to COVID-19. We were just trying to bring value to the marketplace and get different perspectives. And one of the things that has been consistent with all of our guests is staying in contact with your database, your past clients, your current clients, your
sphere. All the time.
And, you know, whether it be handwritten notes, drop-bys, all this stuff. Well, video, we talk about video. Video's not going away. Video's here to stay in today's day and age with Zoom meetings. And what better video guy to bring on with your database than Frank? So, Frank, tell everybody a little bit about viral and what your company does, because you do work outside of the real estate niche as well.
Yeah. I was getting into real estate out of college. This is before all the portals and Zillow and buyer lead generation sites. They said, go pick a farm in a high turnover area. And consequently, the farm that I wanted is a luxury market in Omaha, Nebraska, where I'm from. And they said, you need to go knock on doors. You need to go to events. You need to go to charity fundraisers, cold call them, whatever, you pick your form of rejection you want. But you need to go meet homeowners in your target market wherever you want to work. And for me, I wanted to pick a little more upper sales price. But I knew at a young age that not everyone I talked to would want to sell their home like right when I met them. That's kind of ridiculous. And they had no idea who I was from anyone else. I mean, I'm just some other guy saying I'm a real estate agent. So I needed some way to like stay in touch with all these people who are very educated, very affluent. And I also need to prove to them I knew something about marketing, because that's essentially what someone's hiring you to do, is to market their home. So remember those little flip cameras? I would get on a flip camera and start shooting some helpful videos on a little flip camera and send them out. At the time, it was pretty novel. Put them up on Facebook, email, social media, you know, and it worked great. It was basically what they talk about in Gary Keller's book, the 36 touch model, or then at the time, the 33 touch. The idea is just to touch your database a lot. You know, that's the concept. And it was great. It was inexpensive, and people spent time with you online. They got to know you. And lo and behold, I realized, hey, this is kind of a common need. And it turned into a business. And about 50 employees later, and where we are today, with hundreds of clients around the country, we interview you just like we do, Mike, on a webcam. Or if you can step it up and use a little better camera, it's up to you. But essentially, you publish two educational Q&A videos a month, adding value, explaining something, giving a market update, answering a question. Maybe telling a story of how you help somebody, you know, something that, you know, people actually want to watch versus your sales pitch.
Sure.
And you send it out. And what this does is over time, you know, it gives you a system to stay in touch with your list on social media with video and email. But also now what we do is we find direct mail is also pretty good. So we take that information you have in your videos and also mail it out to your list once a month. So with your two video touches online with social media boosting and a monthly piece of direct mail, you have this solid touch program for your database where you're constantly staying in touch, where it's not a bunch of canned stuff. And that's where you have to really make a big jump, where a lot of the, you know, cheap material out there is kind of your pre-written, canned, packaged, you know, drip stuff that's pretty irrelevant.
You mean like the time zone, daylight savings emails that you get from 20 plus emails? Yeah. That's not.
I mean, it's just not in 2020. You know, not when there's complicated algorithms and personalization and behavioral targeting and, you know, in that type of world. But, you know, if you want to move beyond just kind of the canned crap, I'll say, so to speak, that you just kind of vomit on your list and move up where you're starting to create your own stuff. That's a jump. That's a jump. And our firm is here to help you. And we make it easy by interviewing you on a webcam to create those videos and then optimizing them and sending them out. And we even give you the scripts and topics to talk about. But at the end of the day, like, you know, when you're working with buyers, all you have to be is the merchant of the listing. Like, they don't really care about you as the buyer's agent so much. Like, you could say there's a buyer presentation, but look, you're opening the door, you're helping put the offer in. I want the house, right? Mm-hmm. On the listing side, they really want to know the agent. You have to market yourself. They really want to know, like, who is this trusted advisor that I'm going to spend, I don't know, in luxury, what, a $30,000 more commission on to get this home sell, you know, all in. Mm-hmm. And that's what this helps you do. So ask me whatever you want. I have spent the past 11 years of my life helping people get business from their database.
So one of the things that I love about video is people's authenticity comes through. So, you know, one of the things that you encourage agents to do eventually, because, you know, last year we did 34 trainings and, you know, not a scientific poll, but I would ask the audience, you know, raise your hand if you have a YouTube channel, raise your hand if you're putting at least, you know, two videos a month on your YouTube channel. And Frank, consistently 10 to 20% of agents would raise their hand, said differently, 80 to 90% wouldn't. So I said, look around this room, what better opportunity, what your competition isn't doing this. So even in this Zoom world that we're in right now, and we're going digital, and so many people are more and more comfortable with video, you know, I guarantee if I fast forward at my next 34 trainings, I raise a hand, you know, maybe it's 33% of the group is consistently putting a couple videos on their YouTube channel, but the vast majority still aren't comfortable. When I say aren't, I'm talking real estate agents, mortgage professionals, whoever it might be, fill in the blank, aren't comfortable putting content, putting video out there. And I believe the fastest way to attract opportunities and position yourself as an expert, a leading authority, is put amazing content out there, and you guys help give some guidance on some topics, as well as, you said, for those agents that maybe aren't ready, they don't have someone that could hit the record button, you will actually do the interview and then edit it and put some nice little bullet points and their contact information. Yep. See, that's where I think your service is the most valuable, is the editing. I'm sure, no offense to what you guys do, I could get editing done a lot cheaper, but just knowing that it's done consistently, and each year I'm going to be putting out at least 24 educational videos that are fully edited, have some great visuals. You know, to me, what's a new sale worth? And I'll cheerfully pay for that.
Yep. Yep. All of our staff is right here in Omaha, Nebraska, where we're based out of. So
Omaha, Nebraska. My last guest I had on last week was Jeff Cohn from Omaha, Nebraska. I thought Omaha was going to be a bunch of cornfields. I remember hearing about Omaha.
There's some nice houses there.
Crow's song, you know.
Yeah, there's some nice houses there. A lot of Warren Buffett money.
A lot of money.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if anybody has a question, just like on all our shows, we are going to be posting this on our YouTube channel, and we'll be posting the replay to our groups. But if you have any questions, please chime in on the Facebook feed that we're doing. And if it comes in through the replay or after the fact, I'll make sure, if you ask it of me, I'll get back to you. If you ask it of Frank, I'll make sure we get that, Frank. Frank, you know, just to give someone a little bit better idea, where should they go to find out more? There's other services out there, but I've been using Viral, your company, since 2013, I believe, maybe 12. So 7 or 8 years. And, you know, I'm obviously very pleased. That's what we have you on. We're doing, in 1 week, we're doing the first ever virtual luxury designation open to all brands, independents, as well as franchises. Our designation, as you know, Frank, doesn't have any previous luxury sales requirements. And folks, I have Frank coming on the bonus day. Yeah. The bonus day is going to be just people that are rock stars that I think the people that invested in the designation should get to know. And Frank is one of those. So
thank you.
You're welcome. This was kind of impromptu. I had you on there today, but what's the best, where should somebody go to find out more information about your service and that sort of thing?
Well, one of the things we started doing, so I go to our website, getviral.com, and I want to teach you marketing. So I want to teach you how to position yourself as the expert authority and guide, local economist of choice, the go-to expert. That's all perception and marketing and videos and content that you're putting out online. I think everyone gets that. And I teach a class every single week for our clients every Monday at noon. So I actually have a class coming up today, and the entire syllabus is on our website. You can go to getviral.com and click classroom, and you'll see the 24 lessons. It's two semesters a year. You can actually join anytime of the client training, where I go really deep on the viral marketing plan to get the most out of your database. And you're welcome to join us. Go sign up, and you're welcome to join us on that client training. And get a feel for it, what it's like to work with us, hop on a training, see if you like the in-depth model of how to market yourself. And then if you like that, download the video marketing plans on the website, and you can request a strategy call, and you'll talk to us. And we give a 90-day money-back guarantee. So we've had clients that just, the videos are just, they're not ready yet. The with all due respect, the personal development, maybe the self-esteem, lots of human issues to be on video. You ain't publishing to this, and we'll give you your money back. You're not ready. We've had people send out stuff to the database where everyone unsubscribes and no one cares, because these were a bunch of like a lot of, usually that's very unbranded buyer lead generation where nobody wants to hear from you.
Sure.
We've had people that have signed up where like, this is just not for you, and we give you all your money back. But if it is for you, you keep going, you make money at it. So I'm pretty proud of that you can actually get going with our company for 90 days and to see if it's a fit. And if it's not a fit, we literally write you a check back for the money.
No, that's 90-day money back.
Because you don't know, man, until you do it. You don't know until you get on video and you get a feel if you're comfortable. And some people aren't comfortable. And honestly, I'm great with video. I'm happy to do Zoom meetings, but my real comfort zone personally is writing. Writing is what I'm the strongest at, but not everyone's a good writer, and some people are more comfortable with videos. So you have to kind of find your media that's best for you. But for most of our clients, they're just getting started, like publishing. And we're a good personal trainer and coach to help you out with that. And Mike, you've certainly done a wonderful job with that. You should be very proud of yourself with where you've gone from to where you are now, like coaching other, you know, luxury agents to succeed all over the country. So, yeah.
I appreciate that. Yeah. But yeah, video, I mean, if you look at my timeline, you know, good is good enough. You know, most real estate agents are recovering perfectionists, and they don't like the way they look, or they put on their COVID 20 pounds or whatever it might be. Mm-hmm. And so I would tell people, just get out there, do it. And that's what makes it, that your authenticity comes through. And that's really why people want to do business with you. They want to do with people that are real and not fake. Right. And so, you know, video, try it out 90 days. And like you said, you might break down your barriers and you might step out of your comfort zone, but that's where I think the magic happens, by the way. And so most people's comfort zone isn't on camera, isn't on video. Yep. What do you recommend? Do you have a tip or advice for anybody that, whether it just be Facebook Live or whatever, do you have any tips for people that have anxiety, that maybe they don't like the way they look, or they have anxiety about getting, they don't like the way they sound?
Here's my best advice. So when you start off in business or sales, you have to talk to people. So normally I would say most people just sit behind a desk and are lucky to maybe G-chat some of their colleagues, and that's their kind of their work existence. But now you're going into business for yourself. So now you have to go make sales and talk to new people, which is sales training 101. So you're kind of taught more of the, I would say more of the, maybe the Brian Buffini approach of pop buys. Let's go meet people face-to-face, because face-to-face communication, you get full feedback. You can read the person, work with the person. You do face-to-face events and strategies. But then you realize, man, that's really inefficient. So you start trying to figure out, you know, how can I get more done in less time? And you graduate to now selling on the phone. Phone's great, but you have less feedback. You can't see the body language. You can't adjust your messaging just right. You have to have a little more skill. And you go, man, this is a lot of work doing this one-to-one. Maybe I should do a webinar or workshop. So now instead of doing it one-to-one over the phone, now you do it in a workshop or webinar, but now you even have less feedback because the audience just sits there and you're just talking. mm-hmm. you know, and it's more difficult to communicate. And then you go, man, what if I could start doing this on video and reach even more people and scaling more or use media? And now no one's, you get zero feedback. And that really is the challenge, is how do you build your communication skill where you go from one-to-one face-to-face to on the phone to end-to-one-to-many, and finally through the scaling of the use of media. And that's where viral marketing comes in. And we're going to help you with that journey because, you know, viral marketing really is kind of a personal development in disguise of how are you able to now communicate at scale using media, like I said before, as opposed to having to do one-to-one. Now, you have to do both. They complement each other. I'm not saying you still need to do the basics, but when all that comes together, when you use media correctly, video and podcasting or whatever it is, a lot of the people that you speak on the phone with will have already spent a lot of time with you, and it makes the conversation so much easier. If there was one metric I could give someone to measure their success with internet marketing and video marketing and whatnot, it's certainly not the number of views. It's not the number of clicks or the size of your email database or whatever it is. It's really how many minutes has your target market spent with you online? So, you know, if you can get your target market, which is homeowners, the buyers in your list, to actually consume your content and to spend time with you, when you show up on that presentation, you're competing for a listing, they're already going to know you. And it makes it so much more easier to win over. So those are my best tips. I think the answer to that question is understand it's a personal development journey and you want to get better at those things. And one of the easiest ways to get better at it, as opposed to you having to sit in front of a video camera, just talk, which is weird, is you do an interview, just like we're doing here. Mm-hmm. And you have somebody interview you on a Zoom meeting like this to get you to say stuff that's comfortable and mm-hmm. make sure you're lit well and you're positioned right in the frame and you're doing well, just Q&A. And then we just edit ourselves out of that video and you have a nice little video for you to publish. So interviewed is like the easiest way, a Q&A interview style with a little prep beforehand is the easiest way to get comfortable communicating through media before you just, you know, pop on a camera and just go. That takes skill. That takes mm-hmm. confidence. Mm-hmm. That's built over time.
That's great advice. Great advice. Do you guys have any on the website, any kind of checklist or report or anything like that, where somebody that's thinking about checking you out, they go to getviral.com and they could just click around.
Everything's there. So the official video marketing plan is on the homepage. You can download that. That's essentially, you know, kind of the position paper that you need to have a touch plan in place for your list. You're spending all this money, all this time on building leads and generating leads. And I mean, come on, it's just naive to think everyone's ready to buy or sell right now.
Right.
And it's also very short-sighted. And I understand why certain trainers like Mike Ferry tell you they're not going to buy and, you know, right now throw the lead out because you get locked up in the old stuff because your time needs to be focused on the new things. But as your business acumen grows, you realize, man, gosh, I really need to nurture some of this stuff. Like a lot of these, you know, there's services out there now. I can't remember specifically, but they'll take your database and put it in the system and they'll email you every time somebody in your list transacts a home with someone else. So imagine taking your database, friends, family, everyone else, give it to these companies. And whenever they transact, whenever they sell or buy a home with somebody else, you get email notified. So literally just tell you all the business you're missing on your list because you're not staying in touch, you know?
That's a reminder, by the way. You see that, like, oh man, I better call.
Yeah, it's just like it's a giant guilt trip.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
And
I'm kicking something else.
Yeah, I forget where I was going to go with. I forget where I was going with that.
Well, just talking about staying in touch with your clients.
Yeah, you know, look, business is all about picking a target market of haven't met, some people that you don't know. In this case, for the context of this is all of the homes in your county or area that are three times the average sales price, which is what you would consider the luxury market at any market. Mm-hmm. So in Toledo, Ohio, it's going to be a little different price point than say La Jolla, California, but it's still three times the median price. That's where you start getting into luxury. Mm-hmm. And you essentially go get the names and addresses of all of those homeowners and you have a spreadsheet. I don't really know how large that list is, but can't be that large. 1,000, 2,000. It's going to be a smaller part of the market, right? Couple thousand, I don't know, whatever the list is. And you got to figure out, how am I going to meet these people? You know, and it's probably hanging out where the rich live and going to rich fundraisers and, you know.
Yeah, we teach a lot of those, you know, how to build relationships for sure.
Yeah, I think one of the things that I'll never forget what you shared with me was the business owner mastermind was, you get together a lot of other people who sell to the affluent in the market, the luxury market. So you get the suit guy and the Lamborghini dealership or whatever it is, and you bring them all together at one of your vacant, maybe expensive listings for a free venue. Yep. And you show them the venue, show them the house, and they'll take pictures of it, post it on social media. And then you ask them, you do a little mastermind, help them grow their business. And you say, hey, do you guys know any other wealthy individuals that might need to buy or sell a home, and you get referrals that way?
Yeah.
And I thought that was just such an incredible strategy to build relationships, because when you start going into the more affluent, it really is more referral driven.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. To take the analogy from the movie that was produced in 2000, Meet the Parents, that the circle of trust is very tight at the top. Yeah. And so it's difficult to break into that. It's really easy to get kicked out. So you got to do what you say you're going to do, but people are going to Google you before the appointments. They're going to check you out. People that are considering interviewing you today are looking you up online, looking you up. You know, let's face it, YouTube is the second largest search engine out there besides Google. And yeah. So people are checking you out. And so if you have videos, if you have content, you know, you're the real deal versus the guy that doesn't. Mm-hmm. So, well, good. Well, hey, I know you got some things to get to, but getviral.com, viral. And looking forward to having you on next week on our luxurydesignation.com event.
Great. Thanks for having me, Michael. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Frank. Appreciate it, guys. The replay of this will be on our YouTube channel. Go to marketingluxurygroup.com, Marketing Luxury Group. If you guys like this or other previous episodes.
What was that? Show me that.
See this?
Oh, is there a thumbs down the backside?
No, this is this.
Oh, that's the meanie face.
But hey, I got.
Oh, you are too cool, man.
Got this here. But I don't have the new caring one. The new caring That's one, good. I don't have that one. Have you seen that new option on Facebook?
I haven't.
No, you gotta go on there and like
it. I'm not up to speed on my emojis on Facebook. I need to get better at those.
All right. Say hi to that beautiful wife of yours. We'll talk to you later.
All right. See you guys. Peace. Take care. Bye-bye.